other places, as I mentioned, we did have some pilots already where the courses are running for some time.
This the course will be starting July?
We are just about 60 students. First effort would be to ensure that 60 students are checked.
Basically, the financial skilling is one aspect of exchange focus, where we are actually ensuring that people are given the right kind of skills so they will be able to enter into the workforce and then possibly help achieve the financial inclusion almost everybody is talking about now. So the long term programs like the one where we are now focusing with WIPS is one such area which we are working on. As I mentioned, there are short term skill based programs which we do with various institutions focus on a particular area, maybe capital markets, maybe banking, insurance, mutual funds. So the short-term 2-3 month programs also we keep doing with various institutions. In the last months, one-year period under the STAR scheme, the NSDC has come up with a skill development scheme. Under that, we have trained close to 10,000 candidates across the country. And besides that, we, as an exchange, we are also focusing on ensuring that the base level financial literacy is important at all levels. So we can interact right from school to the post-graduation. Here, this particular aspect is on the post-graduate level. As an exchange, we believe that financial awareness has to be created even at the school level. So we actually start interventions at the school level. We have an agreement with the Tamil Nadu School Board where we train, and it's not actually training, we teach students of class 8 and class 9 about basics of finance, basics of money as such, not even finance. What is money, what is interest, what is inflation, how inflation affects the savings. So very basics of money and the concepts around savings are taught in a 25-hour program in class 8 and class 9. So that drive is going on for the last 4 years, and we have touched close to 25 lakh students in Tamil Nadu. The same similar drives we have entered into last year with Assam, Nagaland, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand. We just put it in tie with Gonda Gujarat for introducing a school program. So there we are expecting that we will touch a large number of students in Gujarat. So Gujarat has a different model where all schools are connected by way of a broadcast channel. So we are planning to actually use that channel to impart financial literacy to a large number of students. So as NSE tries to, it's critical that people know how to manage their own money, forget about the intermediation and skills. People should know how to manage their own money. So in that sense, we have this kind of program. We have programs at class 11 and 12 with CBSE, Tamil Board. We have vocational programs included in class 11 and 12. As I said, we have types with various universities for BBA and MBA clinical programs. So we are actually trying to reach out to across the board, right from student and school level to the post-graduation level. We are trying to impart basic financial literacy as well as skills which are required to be in the financial services industry. So that is the overall kind of canvas on which NSE works in education.
So actually, I have three questions for you. My first question is, what are the job opportunities after completing PGDMN?
See, the financial market, the biggest role in terms of research. So those are the kind of opportunities that students would be able to explore once they complete this course.
Okay. My next question is, as an educationist, how important do you feel is skill development?
See, the knowledge transfer is one aspect of any program, but knowledge in itself does not necessarily lead to employment. Skill is what will make a person a lot more employable. So, along with the knowledge of the financial markets, we are also helping the student to be skilled on that aspect. So that's going to ensure that not only will he get a job, but he also progresses past this level.
Okay, and my last question to you is, like, what are the essential differences between MBA Finance and PGPM?
The key differentiator is NSE. Okay, the fact that NSE is also not just giving a name, but 50% of the course will be taught by professionals. Okay. So that itself is going to be the key differentiator between an MBA Finance and this program, where you have people from the industry actually coming down and teaching what they really require from a profession. So we are actually getting a hands-on experience. So that's going to be the percent of our current batch of 2015 has got placed abroad. So considering, you know, we talk about that the economy is doing well, but in Bengal there are not too many jobs. So this is an institute that manages 10% of its students getting a job internationally. In fact, companies like KPMG, ITC, ITRA, so they've all come and recruited students. Philips has been a big recruiter. From the financial market side, KPMG has shown an interest as well. So if you have a lot of job opportunities in the financial market, along with the brokerage community, the community which also sees that there's going to be a lot of scope for this program.
On financial and market side, obviously banking, insurance, mutual funds, multiple areas are available on the as openings for most of the students. Even within the capital market side, things are changing so dramatically. When just about, say, 2000, before 2000, we just had one single product, which is ETFs. 2000 numbers, we have seen slowly the derivatives have taken over, equity derivatives have come. Over a period, we have seen currency derivatives coming in, interest rate derivatives have been introduced recently. The complexity and the product integration is consistently growing. So the finance professionals who are coming out of programs like this will be able to really look at design of the product, risk management, and selling. So the entire set of amount of issues can be addressed by professionals coming out of a program like this, because they will be equipped with all the knowledge which is required to manage complex products. Going forward, obviously the product innovation is going to continue in financial services industry. Financial services industry is one industry where product innovation is a constant feature. So for people to have that grounding from theoretical side from the institute and the practical grounding from the exchange is a critical component, and it really is going to give these students the extra edge to really get into the financial industry. As Vidhu was mentioning earlier, if you really see most banks, the so-called top-notch international banks, if you go to their treasury desks anywhere in the world, not just in India, it is usually Indians who man those treasury desks. The complex products are usually treated by Indians only. We guys, our people have that innate knowledge. What we are trying to do is own that knowledge from theoretical input from the institute and the practical input from the exchange. That possibly will give them the best of class on both sides and then make them ready for career in the national markets.
This is from Patrika. Just one, two questions from my side. One is, you are absolutely correct that if you go to any treasury desk, you will see Indians doing that. Most of them have IIT backgrounds because they are more, you know, most of them are very maths friendly because you design them in code. So, in your criteria, the program you are talking about, is maths something that you will be looking for among the students who are coming in? That's number one, because for financial market, that's a must. Second is, yes, financial market has gone way ahead. Even we are seeing such funds which didn't exist earlier, like people are funding over the internet just to search for a potential merger and acquisition, forget about market and acquisition, just searching itself. So in this rapidly changing world, what will be your key criteria for the students whom you are getting?
To answer your first question, the course has a very high bent on quantitative techniques. So statistics, QT would essentially be covered. Because you cannot have finance without maths. So it will ensure that a large part of it is already incorporated in the course. But the way the course could be very different is that there would be an application of that. And it's just not restricted to quants. To excel on some areas, there is a very high bent on QT, but not in all possible areas. As far as skills are concerned, the software of NLT, the NLT is learned to train. So there are these skill-based aspects also which is embedded in the program, okay, which helps the students to also get a fair idea of what's actually happening and what they're going to be doing once they start moving.
Any technique who should be able to come in, and mathematics definitely is not going to be the only thing. And financial markets, treasury side is one aspect. There are multiple openings within the financial markets, right from treasury fund, risk management obviously is again a quantitative intensive kind of a requirement. But there are areas which like compliance, money laundering, anti-money laundering, various aspects which are getting opened up for a period. So non-math students do have a great role to play in financial services industry. But as Vidul mentioned, there is a significant amount of training which is going to be given as part of the training, like the program itself on the quantitative methods. But it kind of gives them a flavor of the financial markets. And they can choose after graduation which area to focus on based on their strengths and their background. So the whole variety of openings are available for students coming out of this particular course.
Thank you.